nakakatuwa na parang at least kakilala ko yung magiging ka-partner ko in the rain. Yeah. And then, pero hindi ko naman in-expect na parang babalik ulit yung friendship na nabuo sa loob ng bahay. No, habang tumatagal kami, as in, I think mas, actually mas deeper pa nga yung connection natin. Unlike nung nasa loob tayo ng bahay ni Kuya.
No, yeah.
Yeah, the more, you know, mature versions.
It's like we have this time where like, okay, we're working work, you know? But then it's like every other time, it's just like, playing around, which we were saying that didn't even feel like work anymore.
Yeah. And so, I think nakakatuwa lang din na dahil nabigyan kami ng pagkakataon, like 6 years to grow individually. And so now na we had reconnected, so I think way better talaga.
Less toxic.
Yes, you know, like more mature.
Chill.
Chill.
You were 16,
yes,
no?
I was 16.
She was 16, I was 15.
Mm-hmm. So, sobrang bata. Tapos ngayon, like, I'm 23, you are?
22. I think we should just name it, like, childish with the power of being 18 plus. So, like...
Yeah, because I think what's also good thing about us, because we bring out, like, the kid version in us. And so, like, because dati, habang tumatagal ka, of course, in life, parang the more guarded you are, the more, alam mo yun, parang mature ka na. And pero pag magkasama kami, I guess lumalabas yung vulnerability namin and yung pagiging bata namin, which is really fun. So with me kasi, I was about to do nanahimik ang gabi.
Okay.
So nasa lock-in na pala ako noon.
Okay.
And then binigay nila sa akin, "Uy, audition for the role Luna and Yana."
Yeah.
So I had two options and then that tinry ko both. Tapos parang I wasn't like really into the story that time because sobrang ano na ako, pasok na ako dun sa story ng nanahimik. So parang nandun na yung focus ko. But I still did gave my best. And then nung nalaman ko na parang, oh, Wattpad. So parang I've never done that. Like first time yan. So parang, you know, I'll try my best. Pero ayun, I'm really glad na nakuha ko si Luna.
I knew, like, literally the first thing that they told me was through this Zoom meeting and, you know, same thing. I was doing a audition for Calyx and Savvy.
Oh.
Yeah, both of them.
Nice.
But then I think I had a little bit of a problem with the Tagalog as well that Savvy had. So I was like, no, maybe you're Calyx. And I was like, oh, okay. Thank you. And then they told me and we did the Zoom meeting and they were like, the first thing that they told me, they were like, oh, you're going to be working with Heaven. And I was like, Heaven? And I was like, Peralero? And they were like, yeah, you know her, right? And I was like,
yeah, I also didn't know what to feel when I heard about you.
Yeah,
so.
But then I expected you to be in the Zoom meeting and she wasn't there. So I was like, oh, okay. So I approached her through DMs on Instagram and she was acting all cool and stuff. I don't know, I felt like whatever happened 6 years ago, it was just 6 years ago. And that's a long time. So like, I kind of not like forgot, but like it was in the past. I wasn't even thinking about it. And when I saw her again, it was just more of, okay, who is this person now? And you know I've changed and I'm like, I don't know how she has been.
I really didn't know what to expect. Like, I thought na, dati kasi, nagtrabaho tayo, Familia Blondina.
Yeah.
Pero like, ano lang kami, like, I was just a guest. You know, like, hindi naman siya major. And so like, that time, like, when I was working with him, like, I really didn't see how, like, if, like, he was passionate about his craft and everything like that. So, you know, like, parang, did you, like, really love the acting na?
No, I went broke. And then I was like, okay, Marco, get your stuff together.
So, yeah, because dati parang hindi naman siya ganun ka-passionate with acting. And like, for me, parang, of course, yun yung one of parang major dilemmas ko was like, oh my God, is it still the same na hindi parin siya ganun ka, like, passionate about acting? But actually, like, he really surprised me. Like, he really did. Like, buong script namin, as in siya mismo may mga kung ano-ano pa siya, talaga alam niya, pinag-aralan niya talaga. Like, ang galing talaga ni Marco ngayon. Like, different Marco. Wait, no joke though.
You're gonna make me blush.
You know, I can definitely see how he loves acting. And that's really like a plus point. So yes.
I love everything about Luna.
Specifically?
Like, how she's so selfless. I think I resonate with that. I'm very selfless. Come on.
Yeah, she
is. How she is like super fun to be around. Like, she has this energy and I like that. Because sometimes ako, sobrang introvert ko. May mga times na sobrang tahimik ko lang, diba?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so, ang bilis ko mapagod. Pero kay Luna, as in 100% every scene. So, kung may 16 sequences kami, naka 1600% ako all the time ng energy. And so, nakakatuwa na pag nalalabas ko na siya, kunyari nadadala ko si Luna in real life, parang mas masaya lahat.
I love to have a role that he was like so into her. Like, no matter how, whatever she does, he's just has this passionate love for Luna that no matter what, he's always gonna try. And I like that because that comes in handy as a reminder for work for us, because it's like, no matter how hard it gets, it's like, come on, you know, let's do it. And she always somehow finds like inside of her this want of being light. And not all of actors or actresses have that. I don't know, it's like I love the traveling part about this job. I always hated being in an office. And so like, I think the most fun part was traveling to places. So like, Boracay was a fun one definitely for me. I didn't really even feel it was work because like, you're at the beach. How can you feel like it's work, you know?
Dun sa waiting shed. Yung teaser natin, remember? Yeah. So it was like super late at night.
Yes, it was.
Super late at night.
It was like
2? 2 a.m. in the morning. And I was getting wet all the time.
Mm.
And then we just can't stop laughing.
Oh, yeah.
We just can't.
Yeah, like, you couldn't.
Yeah, laughing. I couldn't. Like, and I look into Marco's eyes, like, I just laugh. I don't know why. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Yeah.
At 2 a.m. And so, good thing na lang, everyone wasn't pissed. Like, everyone was having fun. So, parang, they understand naman. And I think, yeah, it was one of my favorite memories of us. Yeah, because, I don't know, like, you just, nialabas mo lang talaga tong side ko na sobrang kulit na I really buried. Ako, personally, because I think yung emotions sa binigay ko doon is just so surreal. Like, super... It really came from my heart. Everything. The good, the bad. You know?
Yeah, I agree. Like, I feel like I didn't really give any performance like it before. And it's like... I wouldn't be telling people to watch it if I even know that I didn't do a good job, because like, I really felt it too. When I was in the scene, you know, they say study the lines, bring your emotions and do it. But in that moment, it didn't even feel like a scene. I really did feel the connection with Heaven, which, you know, with Luna. And I don't think there was any more real than that.
Yeah. I never knew that you're gonna come again into my life. And I'm very grateful na bumalik ulit sa buhay ko. You were like a beautiful turning point of my life. And I'm so grateful to have you. I think you just bring out the child in me and like the best version in me. You know, you teach me a lot of things. You keep me grounded. I really hope that we get a lot of work together so I get to see you more. I'm really grateful for you. No joke. Like, you have a piece of my heart. Why?
That's a first.
That's a first? Yeah.
Didn't know. Okay. My turn?
In the handle. You have a letter.
I've been in this industry, we both have, for so long, and I've met so many people that I trusted and I got burnt. And I don't think I want to give up trying and trying, because look, okay.
What?
I do trust you.
Thank you.
Fully. And I do feel safe with you. And the message I told you earlier about having somebody right by your side, understanding where you're coming from whenever you have something to complain on, I'll be that person. I'll be that person that is gonna be right beside you whenever you feel down, whenever it gets hard, whenever you feel like it's impossible to do. I'll just be that happy light, remembering you that it's fine, that we can do it. No matter what they throw at us. I got you. All the way.
All the way. Hi guys, I'm Heaven Paralejo.
And this is Marco Gallo.
And we are on Metro.style.